as we warm up our breathing mechanism, put your hands on your belly and see if you can feel the pulses down here from your diaphragm going up and down with your lungs. Be my echo. Good job, thank you. And you're right, you're well on your way to beatboxing if you're doing that. Well, as we're continuing with using our consonants to help us with our breathing and our singing, we're going to learn another tongue twister. This one says, falling snowflakes, go ahead and say that, from the sky are fascinating fun. Good, so together it goes, falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. Can you try that with me? Ready, go. Falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. Yeah, again, here we go. Falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. Great. So if you need to pause and practice that a few times, that's fine. We are going to be singing it now as part of a vocal warm-up, and with the melody to it, it goes like this. Falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. So will you be my echo? Falling snowflakes from the sky. Falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. Are fascinating fun. Great, so all together, listen first. Falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. See if you can give it a try. Here we go. Falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. Think you got it? Okay, well, we're gonna try it two speeds, slower, and then I'll give you a chance to try it faster. So here we go. Snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. Falling 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 snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. All right, great job. Are you ready for the faster version? We're gonna go back up to the top and try it again. See if you can keep up. Falling snowflakes from the sky are fascinating fun. 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 All right, great job, great job. If that was tricky for you, don't worry. I'm sure over this winter we'll be able to give it another try. And anytime you want. It's a great tongue twister just to practice and get your mouth moving and woken up. Awesome. Well, now, will you please be my echo?
So me, so, so me. So me, me, so me. Me. So, so, me, me, so, me.
job singing with your hand signs and echoing me. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy today's lesson. I'm excited to share with you a beautiful Hebrew song called Sevivon Sov. Sevivon Sov stands for dreidel. It's a game that people from the Jewish faith play whenever they're celebrating Hanukkah. So here's a picture of a dreidel if you've never seen one. And on each of the four sides, there's a letter. The letters are from the Hebrew alphabet, and they are Nun, Gimel, Chai, and Shin. And I just learned this year that it's an acronym for the Hebrew phrase Nes Gadol Haya Sham, which means a great miracle happened there. When they play this game, they spin the dreidel, and they can win gold coins, which is so fun, right? Well, along with spinning the dreidel to play this game during the time of Hanukkah, they light a candle on the menorah every night for 8 nights. If you've never seen a menorah, here it is. Every night they'll light one of these 8 candles and say special prayers. Well, our song today is all about spinning the dreidel and remembering the great miracle. So you'll get to hear the song in the beautiful Hebrew language, and then you'll get to hear the translation in English. As we are listening and enjoying the music, we're also going to practice playing along. So you need to choose one instrument that you can use to help us play along. So pause, go get your instrument, and come right back. All right, I chose my scraper. What did you choose? It's okay if you didn't choose this, whatever you chose. If you chose your cup, you're tapping on it. If you chose your sticks, you're clicking them together. If you chose your shaker, you can shake it to the rhythm. So here's our rhythm for our A section. We're going to be saying or thinking, dreidel spin, dreidel spin. And the rhythm for that would be toddy ta, toddy ta. So let's try that on our instrument. Ready, go. Toddy ta, toddy ta, toddy ta, toddy ta. Fabulous. And we're going to keep continuing to repeat our ostinato throughout the A section, just like that. I will tell you, it moves pretty quickly. So let's try just a little faster. Ready, go. Dreidel spin, dreidel spin, ta-di-ta, 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 ta-di-ta. Perfect. Just like that. Then in our B section, we get a little bit of a break, and we're just going spin, 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 or ta, 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 ta. Got it? Those are our two parts, and that's it. As you're listening to the beautiful music and the instruments from Israel, I hope you really enjoy listening to Sevivon Sov. Doesn't it? Hey, you did such a great job. Let's try it one more time, though, just in case it was a little too fast and you need one more shot at it. We'll go one more time so you can really listen to the music this time, focus in on that rhythm pattern, and hear the beautiful language and instruments of the Israeli people.
Thank you.
good job again playing along. Thanks so much for enjoying that with me. And here's the next part of our lesson. Do you remember our sleigh ride body percussion from last time? Let's see what you remember. Our A section was that pat, clap, snap, clap that we did slow and then fast, right? And then our B section, going for a ride, going for a ride, going for a ride. Yeah, six times through that. Great. Okay, so you've got that. Our C section, we counted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Snap. Good. And then toddy, toddy, tap, tap. You've got it. We did our hand jive. Let's review our hand jive quickly. Yes, very, very good. I think you've got it. Let's try it with our music again and enjoy one last time through Sleigh Ride. Section, right? So that's, what is again? Rondo form. Good job. Awesome. Thank you. Will you please help me review our winter snowflake song from the last time? Now, we're not going to go grab an instrument. We're just going to add in our claps and our snaps where they originally were after those rhyming words. All right, let's give it a try.
1, 2, ready, sing. Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snowflakes falling, shimmering all around.
Very good. All right, we're going to get to sing that song a couple more times, so don't worry. But I do want to show you these rhythmic building blocks we're going to be using today to compose some rhythms that we can use within our song. So here's our first rhythm, and it says, snowflake sparkling. Can you say that with me? Snowflake sparkling. Yeah, and that says, toddy, toddy. Very good. So if you use that building block, those would be the rhythms you would be clapping or using. Our next rhythm says, on the ground. Can you say and clap that with me? On the ground. Great. And then our next one says, slow falling. Say and clap that with me. Slow falling. Great. And then our last one says, shimmer. Give it a try. Shimmer. Beautiful. Now, in a few moments, I'm going to give you the opportunity to pause the video and make up your own rhythm pattern from these building blocks. But first, I wanted to share some of mine with you so you could just get a feel for what I'm looking for and what I'd like you to try to do in your composition. So will you say and clap my first rhythm that I made up with me? Ready, go. Snowflake sparkling on the ground. Shimmer, shimmer. So you can see we have four choices, but I decided not to use one of them, and I used one of them twice instead. I used shimmer two times. That's okay. You can do that. You can reuse a pattern within your composition. How many building blocks did I choose? Four, that's right. You have to choose four to use. You can use one more than once, that's fine, but you have to choose four so that we have a total of eight beats. Okay, because every single card has two beats on it. Remember, a toddy gets two sounds on, one beat. A ta is one sound on, one beat. So every single one of our cards has two beats. All right, so if we put four cards out there, that gives us eight beats. I know, math and music, who knew? Okay, well here's another one of my rhythms. Let's just give it a try. So you know another option, another way you could lay them out. Just start to get creative. There's lots of different ways. Ready, go. Slow, falling, snowflake, sparkling, shimmer, on the ground. Very good. All right, now you are gonna get a chance to go and do this on your own. You can write it on paper and just make it up. I'm gonna put them on the screen so you see your choices. Or if you would like to, in Schoology, I have a digital version for you to use. You do not have to do it on Schoology. It's just there if you want to be able to like click and move the blocks where you want to do it, okay? Totally your choice. Either way, you're just going to compose your own rhythm somehow so that you can use it in this next section whenever we try to put it in the song. So pause and go write your rhythm. Okay, good, you have your rhythm written. Now, every single time we're gonna sing the song, we're gonna clap the rhythm I made up on the bottom, then you're gonna get to clap your rhythm. You're gonna see me count to eight, and that's your eight beats to fill in your rhythm. You're gonna get to clap your rhythm three times. So keep it handy, because you're gonna clap yours three times. I'm gonna give you three different rhythms before you clap yours, okay? You ready?
One, two, here we go. Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snow is falling, shimmering all around.
Say my rhythm. Snowflakes sparkling on the ground. Shimmer, shimmer. Your turn.
Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snow is falling, shimmering all around.
My rhythm. Slow, falling, snowflakes sparkling, shimmer on the ground. Your turn.
Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snow is falling, shimmering all around.
On the ground, snowflakes sparkling slow, falling shimmer. Your turn.
Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snowflakes falling, shimmering all around.
Very good job clapping your composition after mine. That was so, so good. If you need another try, you can always rewind it back and try again. Now, we're gonna try something else new before we finish with our song. We're only gonna do two rounds of this one. And this is called improvisation. That means we are making it up on the spot. So instead of clapping a rhythm you see across the bottom, I'm just gonna make up a rhythm and clap it to you. And then you are gonna make up a rhythm and clap it to me. Okay, there's no right or wrong. And if you're really scared or nervous, a great thing to do is just start off with ta's and just keep a steady beat. And then if you get brave and you think you can add in a toddy, that's okay. You could throw in one or two, or just do straight ta's. That's okay. We're just trying to get you used to understanding and feeling comfortable with making up your own rhythms on the spot. So we'll do a similar thing. Sing the song. I'm gonna make up a rhythm. Then you make up a rhythm. I'll show you your eight beats. And then we'll sing the song. And then I'll make up a rhythm. You make up a rhythm. We'll sing the song one last time to wrap it up, okay? You've got it, sing along, keep your claps and snaps going with me, and be brave and make up a rhythm and improvise for me.
One, two, here we go. Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snowflakes falling, shimmering all around.
My turn. Your turn.
Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snowflakes falling, shimmering all around.
My turn. Your turn.
Winter snowflakes sparkling, shining on the ground. Winter snowflakes falling, shimmering all around.
I usually avoid the bell, but I forgot today. All right, well, thank you so much for singing along with me, for improvising, for being brave and trying to make up a rhythm on your own. Fabulous work. I saw this book, and it's based on one of my favorite songs that I love to listen to this time of year. I first heard this song when I was in high school, and I thought it was hysterical. And then when I taught high school, I found an a cappella arrangement of this song for choir, and I had my high school choir kids sing it, and they had never heard it before, and they thought it was a hoot too. So when I saw this book, I was super excited, and I knew I had to share it with you because it's such a silly and fun song. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. And the song, the girl explains all the reasons why it's clearly a good idea for her to have a hippopotamus as a Christmas gift. So I think you'll really enjoy it. The song was actually written in 1953 and sung by a 10-year-old girl named Gayla Peavy. She was from Oklahoma, so not far from here. And they actually had this little girl sing the song. So the recording we're listening to, this is Gayla Peavy. It's the real version of her doing it. Well, the song became very, very popular. And the Oklahoma City Zoo
even bought a hippopotamus to give to Gayla Peavy. They actually kept it at the zoo, obviously, but they bought it in her honor, and the hippo's name was Matilda. And so it's just a really fun story. The song is so cute and fun, and I think you'll really enjoy it. So enjoy listening through the book and the song of I Want a Hippopotamus for Christmas.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. Don't want a dog, no dinky tinker toy. I want a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. I don't think Santa Claus will mind you. He won't have to use our dirty chimney flue. Just bring him through the front door, that's the easy thing to do. I can see me now on Christmas morning, creeping down the stairs. Oh, what joy and what surprise when I open up my eyes to see a hippo hero standing there. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. No crocodiles, no rhinoceroses. I only like hippopotamuses, and hippopotamuses like me too. Says a hippo is a vegetarian. There's lots of room for him in our two-car garage. I'd feed him there and wash him there and give him his massage. I can see me now on Christmas morning creeping down the stairs. Oh, what joy and what surprise when I open up my eyes to see a hippo hero standing there. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. No crocodiles or rhinoceroses. I only like hippopotamuses, and hippopotamuses like me too.
So I have this rhythm right here, and we have some pictures. We have a picture in right now. We're in the winter time, and when I think of winter, I think about time with my family. So I have my family, and I have time here. So I want you to clap the word time. Here we go. One, two, ready, go. Time. How many claps did you just do? Only one, that's right. Anytime that we see a clock, we're going to say time and clap one time. If we see family down here, it's like a mom and a dad and grandma and grandpa and some kids and grandkids. So we're going to see if we can clap the word family there. Here we go. One, two, clap the word family. Ready, go. Family. How many syllables did you have? Oh, two. That is absolutely right. So I want you to see if you can clap one time on all the clocks and say time, and then clap two times on all the families that you see. Here we go. One, two, ready, and go. Time, 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 time. Time, 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 time. Time, family, time, family, time. Time, time, time. Now, if I take away a clock, what do you think we're going to do? If there's no clock there, what are we going to do? I'm taking away a few clocks. Do you think we're going to set anything there? Nope, we're not going to say anything on those. We're going to leave them blank. Do you think we just jump right down here? No, each one of these squares is a beat. So we have to still do this beat, even though there's not a picture there. Let's see if we can do that. One, two, ready, and go. Time, 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 family, time, family, time, time, time. Now, on all of these clocks, can you go, go, attend? Can you do that for me? Ready and go, go, attend, go, attend, go, attend. That is the first three phrases I need you to be able to do. So we're going to go and do that. Ready and go, go, attend, go, attend. Die gay like life. Die gay like a go attend. This is in a different language. It is Taiwan. It's from Taiwan. It's a folk song from Taiwan. And this song is about a lantern and it's shining brightly. So we're going to have, anytime that we have three clocks, it's go attend. Now the first clock here is die gay la ga ga go attend. Die gay la ga go attend. Okay, so we're going to put all this, put those last two lines together. Die gay like a go-a-ten. So, putting it all together, we have go-a-ten, go-a-ten. Die gay like a go-a-ten. Let's see if we can put that with the music. Go.
Go attend, go attend, die gay like a go attend, go attend, go attend, die gay like a go attend.
Then we're going to do it in English. And those words are lantern bright, lantern bright, light the way, my lantern bright. So in here, we're going to do lantern bright. Lantern bright, light my way. Light the way, my lantern bright. Let's do that again. Here you go. Lantern bright, light the way, my lantern bright. Let's try that again. Ready and go. Lantern bright, light the way, my lantern bright. So that's the whole song. So let's see if we can get that in there as well this time. Here we go. Now we're going to do the English.
Lantern bright, light the way, my lantern bright, bright, lantern bright, light the way, my lantern bright. Lantern bright, light the way, my lantern bright, bright, lantern bright, light the way, my lantern bright.
All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed learning a different culture song, and let's move to the next part of our lesson.
As we review Amani Utube. Amani Utube knows we need help to carry on our load. Amani Utube knows we grant us peace, give us courage. Amani Utube knows we grant us peace, give us courage. Amani Utube knows we. Rocky and the way is dark. Amani Utube knows we. Every road has a different fork. Amani Utube knows we. Grant us peace, give us courage. Amani Utube knows we. Grant us peace, give us courage. Amani Utube knows we.
Great job. Thanks for reviewing and singing along with me. Just a reminder, do you remember what Amani Utube na Ustawe means? That's right. It means grant us peace, give us courage. So we're singing the translation to our Swahili words as we go along through the song. Well, we do have another section to learn, but we're going to wait until after the winter break to learn that. I just wanted to keep it fresh in our minds and review it with you today. And I know Miss Brecht is working on the motions. So whenever you practice singing along with me, you should try to do the motions she has taught you as well. Thanks for singing along.